Hello again. We're reading today The Snow Lion, a book written by Jim Helmore and Richard Jones. Caro and her mom went to live in a new house at the top of a hill. The walls were white, the ceilings were white, even the doors were white. There were lots of places for Caro to explore, but she wished she had someone to play with. Then, one day, she heard a noise. "How about a game of hide and seek?" said a deep, gentle voice. Caro turned around. There stood a lion as white as snow. "Where do you come from?" Caro asked. "Oh, here and there," said the lion. He leant against the white wall and vanished. The wall winked at her, and Caro laughed. They played hide and seek all day. The next morning, Caro and the lion looked out of the window and saw two boys. Their colorful kites swooped and soared. One of the boys waved, but Caro shyly looked away. "Come on, let's play again," she said. All week, the lion and Caro climbed and slid. They raced and they chased. Then, one day, the lion looked thoughtful. "Have you tried a slide in the park?" he asked. "I like playing here with you," said Caro. "I'll still be here when you get back," the lion replied. So Caro went to the park. When she got there, she found the boy who had waved at her yesterday. The boy's name was Bobby, and he could slide almost as well as the lion. "Can catch me," laughed Bobby. But by now, Caro was very good at chasing. "How was the slide?" asked the lion that night. "Bumpy," smiled Caro. "But I missed you." The next day, Bobby asked Caro if she'd like to play with his friends. "Give it a try," said the lion. "But I won't know anyone," she whispered. "You'll have a great time," said the lion, "and you do know Bobby." So Caro went to Bobby's house, where they all built a parrot spaceship kitchen. After they had reached the moon, they buried their treasure and ate plenty of chocolate cake. The next morning, Caro's mom said, "I think it's time we put some color into this house, don't you?" "I like it white," said Caro uncertainly. Just then, the doorbell rang. Her mom had invited all Caro's new friends for a painting party. Soon, the house was full of oranges, reds, blues, and greens. And by the afternoon, everyone needed a bath. That night, Caro searched everywhere for the lion. But there were no white walls, or white ceilings, or white doors left. Outside, it began to snow. Soon, the whole hill was white. Down in the garden, something caught Caro's eye. Could it be? "I thought I'd never see you again," cried Caro. "All lions are happiest outdoors," said the lion. "And we've got another friend to play with now." "But I'll miss you." The lion smiled. "And I'll miss you too. But if you need me, you'll know where to look." And she did. And this is the end. What if we decorate our snow lion with snow? A snow to paint at home is very easy to make. We just need to combine the same amount of shaving cream and white glue to get a fluffy paint excellent to use in any winter project. Try it, it's really good fun.